It's Casey Brown TV show. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening to my beautiful people. It's another beautiful day that God has given to us. That's why we are here again. If you're supposed to, please try to subscribe and leave your hand on the notification bell for more videos and updates. This is a platform we learn and to educate ourselves. This is a platform we speak positive speech to people, to motivate people, to lift people back. Because when there is life, there is hope. Don't lose hope. Understand? So, we are here to, you know, to pass information about, you know, people are saying that, when are they going to share this document? Where is this sanatoria or giving documents going to be out? But you guys need to know that Italian rules are parliamentary rules, so there must be, you know, opposition trying to stop this document issue, because you know the previous government, and that they are ruling right now is not an easy one, and many of them are trying to stop it. So, but the Minister of Agriculture, a gun sense person, she's pushing hard for them to pass on this sanatorium to people. And the Minister of Interior also, she's supportive to this idea, and many ministers also. But it's not a easy one, but we need to be patient and be prayerful. Understand? So the Minister of Agriculture is Teresa Bellanova. She belongs to a small party called Eterna Viva, but she won the Minister of Agriculture. So she's going around and seeing things, and she'll find that there are, you know, a lot and many irregular migrants working in agricultural sector and also domestic sectors or so. And she find that many of them don't have documents, and she's seeing the place these people are living. So that's why she bring out these ideas of, you know, giving them documents so that these people can be regular, so these people can, you know, can pay taxes, also can have contribution. Because when you are regular in the countryside, you have contracts, you're working. If your work stop, you can go for unemployment. Understand? Because we pay taxes, we pay contributions so that the government can repay you back to find another job. So these people that is working in agricultural sector, seasonal workers, if that's the season finished, they will be left without no benefits because they are irregular. So now there is coronavirus. This woman said, okay, how are these people coping? How are they, you know, living in this coronavirus, you know, crisis in Italy? So that's why she said, okay, let's pass this law for these people's life to be secure also. We cannot push them behind because they are living in this country. So how would the risk of this coronavirus reduce if they didn't pass this law to them? So that's why she's putting it in the parliament for them to pass the law. So this woman belonged to Italian Viva, asking for 6 months permit, residence permit, but the five-star movement accept only one. So just the prime minister of Italy, that is Joseph Conte, will meet with the head of delegation to find an agreement, possible mediation on 3 months of contract. He's saying 3 months, not the prime minister of Italy. He's saying 3 months, but the minister of agriculture, she said 6 months. So let me continue reading. That will brief you some stories. Okay. In another meeting, and the question of the issue still to be resolved, it concerned the possible duration of resident permits, and therefore of the employment contracts of irregular migrants who work but who are invisible to the state. Italian Viva, with the Minister of Agriculture, Teresa Bellanova, threatened to leave the government if the law of the regularization of laborers, domestic workers, and carers will not be approved. Teresa Bellanova threatened to leave the government if they did not pass this law. If they did not pass this law, she's going to leave the government. She's the one fighting. She's the front line, standing on the front line, saying that they should pass this law. These people have been working for many years without no documents. Understand? Now there is coronavirus. You say we should stay indoors. Where are these people? How are these people living? How are they coping? These people are crowded in ghetto, informal settlements. 10 people in one small hut, 20 in one small hut, and they will say that we should stay 1 meter far from each other. So Why and when and how would this coronavirus issue reduce the risk? So, let me continue reading. The Democratic Party, with the Minister of the South, Giuseppe Provenzano, also push in this direction and works for the mediation. The proposal signed by PD Italia Viva with the presence of ministers of the Interior, Luciano Mongese, forced a temporary contract for 6 months. Renewable also. The Minister of Interior also accepts for these 6 months. She signed for the 6 months. Understand? So, the Minister of Agriculture and the Minister of Interior, they sign and they agree for the 6 months. What happened? But yeah, during in some videos that go viral, the Minister of Labor, Nusia Katafo, does not reject the proposal, but on behalf of the party of the Five Star Movement, place polls that could block the approval of the law. The Five Star are saying they should give one more stay. You see the confusion and the, you know, the problem and the situation that is holding this this sanatoria. You see, the Minister of Agriculture and the Interior Minister, they agreed for these 6 months. Even the Minister of Labor accept the purpose, but the Five Star Movement did not. They said they only approve 1 month. So Luciana reply, it is evident that in full coronavirus emergency, a month of contract will not be the solution to this, which many call a battle of civilization, because she said we are civilized. The world are looking and many people are still watching. They are seeing what is happening. Understand? So, and on which today, the president of the CEI, Gualtiero Bazzetti, also spoke, joining the Pope appeal. You know, Pope also talk about this. They should give these people, they should share these people a document. They should give them that dignity. These people are working. These people are human beings. In this coronavirus, we need to love and share love and hold hands together and fight this virus away. So putting this in irregular migrants or undocumented people aside won't stop the risk. Will not stop the risk of, you know, affecting others. Because these people, their life, because their life is also included because they're living in this country. That's what the government are saying, but some governments don't want, you know, they don't want it. From somebody, God, everything's going to be possible. Do not forget these people, Pope said, and the president of CEO. Bringing on that clear work to the fore, therefore protecting the rights of workers who often live crowded in ghetto, also means protecting them from affecting from this virus. Protecting the health of all entire cities. The scientists say so. They should protect all the health of all the cities. The scientists say so. And the Prime Minister Giuseppe Conte is also taking this into his account. Understand? He's taking it into his account because everybody's life needs to be protected. Because if you are putting some people beside and one of those people contact from this virus, they will still bring it into the cities. They will still be going around. So how will this corona issue reduce? First of all, when there is life, when there is good health, things can change also in people's life. These people are working, not their idols. Many of them are working, agriculture, domestic, in different sectors, but they're irregular. So now many of them cannot access for bonus. So how will these people continue living? Understand? It's only God that knows. So in fact, it will be up to the Prime Minister to find mediation within the majority by meeting the head of delegation. Itella Viva is pressing for this provision to be included in the May decree. So everything depends on the Prime Minister, that is Giuseppe Conte, for him to know the months he needs to pass for them to give to share the documents. If it's 3 months, if it's, because he's saying 3 months, but the Minister of Agriculture, she's saying 1 month, but why the other party are saying one? So he's saying, okay, left for him to think about, because he's the Prime Minister. If he signs, the law will pass. So they will start giving documents. So he's taking it in his account, so he's going through it. So in fact, it will be up to the Prime Minister to find the mediation within the majority by meeting the head of delegation. Italian Viva is pressing for the provision to be included in this May decree. That's the Teresa Bellanova, that is the Minister of Agriculture. She is saying this May. She's pressing so hard. She's pushing so hard for them to pass the decree, for them to pass these measures. Otherwise, it will be too late. Someone is biting that mediation could consist of a 3 months resident permit. The office are already working in this direction, and Tuesday could be the decision. So maybe on Tuesday, I don't know the Tuesday they're talking about, maybe their decision. So let's be looking what is happening. Let's be hoping well. Let's hope well. So many party are, you know, agreed about this approval. Understand? So you see, the Minister of Agriculture says she's going to resign her job from the government if they did not pass the law. For someone to stand for the undocumented migrants is a respect. I respect her for that. Understand? For her to stand for people's lives, for her to fight for freedom of people, for her to fight, understand, for people, for them to know that these people are still living, these people are human beings. Let us bring back humanitarian. Let's bring back solidarity to our lives. Let's bring back love into our life. This thing that is happening in this world, nobody know why. Understand? It's only love can, you know, heal the world. It's only love that can conquer these things that is happening. So with that love in our hearts, the world will still be a problem. So we need to love ourselves. So my brothers and sisters, let's hope. This is the update. You know, the Minister of Agriculture, she said that she's going to resign if they do not pass this law. So they leave all this problem to the Prime Minister to think of it, because they already, he said, is in my table, is in my account, I'm going through it. So I know the type and the kind of documents, if it's 6 months or 3 months, because he said 3 months. But because of the press of this, the Prime Minister of Interior, that's the Minister of Interior and the Minister of Agriculture, because of the press they're putting in him, so let's hope for. Understand? Let's hope for. So today, this is today updates. More updates will be coming in. I know many updates will be coming in. So you need to be connected so that I'll be dropping what is their decision. We need to know what are they saying about this senatorial, so that we can know what if there is, you know, positive and a better, you know, hope for us. So what we are thinking for. So we need to be prayerful, so we need to love each other as one. So my brothers and sisters, you need to stay blessed and stay well and stay safe. Also wash your hand regularly and wear your mask when going outside, but when necessary. Okay. Understand? I know all of you where it's open right now, but be careful. You can go where you want to go, but be careful. Understand? Be careful. Wear your mask always. Always put on your mask. Understand? So when you come back, when you come back for shopping or work, wash your hand. It's very good. So see you on my next video, and stay blessed. More updates will be coming in, and share this video and like the video. So please like the video and share to your friends and family. Please, let's support ourselves, and see you on my next video. Bye for now. Love you.